So, the second part of my presentation, I'm now showing the software. This frame, this window here is Microsoft Access. And the menu with some icons. And we'll place the show. The first table I show you is the table of the authors. I have 287 authors entered, and I can look up every single author and show the files connected to it. So, here is a list of works, as I explained. Works as a table. I have 1,300 works entered. Every record contains the author, the date, type, issue, title, and whether it is confidential, and I can jump this record. So, for example, I can filter this big list by author. For example, Robertson. Now you see I have 416 records material from Bill Robertson. Or I take Margot, 276 records. The routines by Margot, all lectures, articles. And of course, LRH, about more than 10,000 issues, not issues, works. Every Ability magazine is one work. Every HCB, every book, every lecture is one work. For example, let's choose booklet. These are types. I have a lot of different types, like Ability magazines, advice letters, books, booklets, PTBs, PPLs, celebrity magazines, Certainty, Shake Sheets, VABs, EDs, and FNOs, and FSM newsletters, HCOBs, and HCOPLs, and FN letters, and so on. For every issue which I found, I put in a record here in this issue table. So now I can say booklet, and choose only booklets by LH. And I find 310 booklets. Or we take the books by LH. 284 books by LH. Not only the non-fiction books, also the fiction books. And you can choose which kind of fiction or the genre Is it adventure, western, fantasy, and so on? And middle age, of course. Oh, BPLs. These BPLs, nearly 600 BPLs have been added. Or BTBs. Or HCBs. Nearly 1800 HCBs. Well, let's look at the chic sheets. Chic sheets. I have admin chic sheets, tech chic sheets, div 6 chic sheets. Let's look one after the other. 54 tech chic sheets. No, that was admin chic sheets like OEC variants. Stuff starters. Then bridge, let's take check sheets for each level. And div 6 check sheets. Upper level check sheets. Different OT levels. Yeah, but you can also put in works from other people. This is a Scientologist. He's a very productive writer, German writer. A lot of Div 6 publications by Kent. Switch off the filter. Now we have all 13,000 works again, and I can show that I can enter the date, like 2nd May 65, and I get all the works in chronological order from the beginning of May 65. Bulletins, policies, bulletin magazine, and so on. If, for example, I choose by a title, Neometrics. That is a filter by title. All the references named Dianetics. I'm looking for book one, that's this one. And I make double click and jump to the record for this entry. This is still the record for the work. And all the fields I want to enter for the work. It's the title, the genre, the author, and the author list, the type, the date, then again the date as a text, because sometimes I just know it's May 50, but I don't know which May. When was it first issued? In which language was it originally written? And who is the editor who keyed in this data? KSW1, I see, was my alias in 2000. Here you see that I started in 2000 with this database. This was the date when I entered this book. So, for this work, there are a lot of issues. Here is the list of issues, and you see 163 issues. Because we have so many translations. I sort by language. There's language here. Steinlich's book was translated in more than 50 languages, and I put for every language, even if I don't have a book or a file. But I know that this exists, and when it was originally issued, this was 2000. Here we see it's even exists in Braille, English Braille version for blind people. Here we see its book. This is a text file. Persian, Farsi, Finnish, French, German, Greek, Hebrew, and so on. You find all these versions. And interesting, of course, here we have an audio version, Benedict's. In German, read by an auditor. I think 20 CDs, music CDs, full of the Dynetics book. 20 hours to read. And if you look here, and find one which is interesting, like this PDF, let's take this as an example, and jump to this record, now here, are all the data for this issue. It's a PDF, still the same author, it's in German, this is the date of issue, the German translation. It's a German title, 371 pages, digitalized by Ron's Ark in May 2005. The book was published by New Era Publications in Copenhagen, 8th printing, ISBN number. And when I had entered this into the database in May 2005, even with that time. So, if I want to read it, I just click here on my shelf, click, and it will open. Here it is, DMSMH 1986. There we are, 371 pages. The issue of 85, copyright 86, New Era, and so on. I close this file. And with this button, I can find a list of all identical issues. So I have this file four times in my hard drive. Three different sources, three different collections, because not everyone is collecting the German issues. see which other PDFs I had. Go to this record and say filter on this, based on this, and I see these 6 PDF versions I have. Let's update this one. Yeah, I see the date on which they are. I jump to this record. Show it here in the list. And I can look up how many issues that we have here. It's 10 files. It's all the same. The same fingerprint. Also, the file size is the same, but the file date and time is different sometimes, although it's the same file. So, and I can look up this document here with a mouse click. Just not sure where it can pick. Yeah. And here a note about it. That's right. It looks on the first glimpse, it could be the version from 1950. But the missing chapters are there. But it could also be a scan of the 78th version and someone added the missing chapters. I don't know. It's just a remark. It is really the original book or not. Could be. Copyright page, so you never know. The copyright page is missing. You can just guess which version it is. So, let's see what else. Which possibilities do we have? Release the filter and go and look for our PABs. Now I can look up the PAB by number. And yeah. It's so reliable. To start software again. Here I can show you a new feature. This is the list of the last references which I looked up. Last one, genetics. So I can jump very quickly to the last work I had looked at. Yeah, and then I look for PABs. See one. And here we have the German PLD number 13. There it is. The German PAB 13. You don't have to know where it is on your hard drive. Or which date it has, or what the name is. But you can find it out, I think, here. You see the file name and the folder, the path. Release the filter. Look for all dynamic books, titles, dynamics in the title. It's nearly 200 works with dynamics in the title. And then I can say HCOB. The title is called. Again, analytics. All HCOBs with Dynetics. Nearly 50 issues. But there are even more possibilities to search. I already showed you, I can go by date, 10 August 1973, and you find the PDS handling bulletin, which is a fake, it's not by LH, illogical. But there are more possibilities to look. If you use this, then here I have my favorites, a selection of the most used references. For example, I find all the bridge, a bridge from 78 and bridge of 75 and so on. Can quick jump there. And look it up. There we are. Rich. Available at your hands. Close it. And so the things which I often use, like OEC volumes, all the tick volumes, all the research and discovery, and so on. Items I put on my favorite list so that they can look them up very quickly, DNSMH, and so on. Then another possibility to look up works is the list of tapes. 5, 6, 4, 10 Psychofiction. There it is, Psychofiction. Fiction. And there I have it, 8 issues. Above 5. Doc, text, PDF, MP3, and real audio. And here I find which series they belong to. It's on level 1 tapes, the number 2 on the level 1 tapes. It's in the center special briefing course, and the new numbering is 405. And on the old numbering, it's the SH Special 42. This is per pilot. We just used the tables from the pilot, made all these tape lists, master tape lists, published these, and I imported these data. So for every lecture I have the information to which series they belong and the number of the series. This is better than the pilot list because he had problems to present the different numberings. For example, this I had to add that it is in a level 1 because it's part of the level 1 cassettes. I added this myself, KSW1IC. My Andreas. So, another way to look for this, I can put in the date, we have this already. I can go by alphabetic titles, for example, TTS. And data and CS1 and so on. It's just by alphabet. You can scroll. Alphabetic titles. Or I can go by author. Oops. That's too quick. Choose this and jump there to PDF and this PD dictionary. So now by author. I key in the author. Let's take myself. 851 issues, articles I wrote, and here they are. Today it's more than 1,000 issues, and 500 of them are in English. So this list is not up to date. The bridge about the chronology, the development of the bridge. So that was by author. For each author, for example, let's take Winslow, we find it's 46 files we have, and here they are, up and down. Efficiency, emotions, how to choose your people, my records, breakfast, and so on. Go to ups and downs. And there you are, with the book. Can I click here? And that is a book, it's not a PDF. There's a PDF. Click, PDF convert. That was by author, but you can also go by language. For example, you meet someone who is from Iran, then you find it's just two titles you have. You can choose between Way to Happiness or Dynamics. Or you meet someone in French, and it's a bit more possibilities. You can choose among these facts, issues, and so on. For every language you can choose. So, next by publisher. I have a lot of publishers here. What was so with this? 155 issues, fantasy stories, LH. fiction published by Arthur Services. By EPUB. Eva Killer. Schach der Erde. That was by publisher and by genre. You can choose a genre like science fiction. Okay, get 95 science fiction, of course, for that age. These are several names by LH. He used Lafayette, the name of it. Oh, I hear I have E. Smith. That was not LH. That was one of LH's favorite science fiction authors, and mine too. In the Heart of LH. Missioners, very important work. I can only recommend reading this. Or you can listen to the tapes. In French, in English, in German. By genre. Oh, you go by ISBN number. If you know the number, you can find the book. Or even by keywords. For example, PDS, PTP, public relation. You can create new keywords and put them to each reference so that you can find back a reference. Imagine you read a reference, a HCB, and think, oh, I would like to find this again under this keyword. So you enter this keyword to the issue and it will end up in this list. So, another powerful thing. I have a list of dates and file names. I mentioned this before. Very useful. And also the dates in files. It's the same problem. You have a lot of text in which dates are mentioned, but not in a standardized form, and I got out these dates, and you can do a full text search for a certain date in all the material. Very powerful, but slowly. But for some research, it is very valuable. So, now I want to show you another feature. Let's go by date. It's a lecture, study and intention, study date. Jump to this. Here are the issues. And here are the series. So this belongs to six different series. It's in the study tape version 81, 75, 87, and 90. Also in the center special briefing course, old number and new number. taken an example. PTS handling reference. Here it is. And besides the issues, six different issues, German, English. I have put keywords. Fake or PDS, and I made a cross reference to another issue because in the LHED 241 int potential trouble source, this reference was mentioned. So if I study this, I find out that it is mentioned in this reference, and so I can jump directly to the LHED to take a look at that. Now in the LHED, it's also called potential trouble source. It's an LHED date 74, the number entered by myself, the date 2007. I have two versions of it, the English one only in print form and the PDF in German. So here's the PDF in German. I scanned this from my yellow PDSSP pack, so it was in the 80s. And I have a second entry telling me it's a hard copy in my folder PDSSP detection, which I got from Marianne. So I can find it back without the need that I scanned it in. If later I need this, then I know where to find, we'll scan it in and enter a third record with the scan of this pitch. But I have here a cross reference. It says the issue refers to HCB 10th of August 73 PDS entry. So that gives me more information. And in studying one with the other, I can quickly jump to the other. That's for research helpful. And of course, I can enter more of these cross references, as many as I want, and as it makes sense. We'll show another use of this cross-reference. Start with the lecture. This lecture, expanded grades in training by LH. This date. I have only one issue, it's an MP3 file. And here is my note that this relates to a lecture, another lecture. This tape was mentioned this morning. The May tape was mentioned by LH in his lecture, 21st July, expanded grades, and should be played in this dialectics congress. That's what he said. So I jump to this and find out, I don't know the title, I just know the date, and we have no issues. This is missing reference. And here you see the worth, value of differentiate between work and issue. I have no issues of this, but I know this work exists because LH mentions it in his lecture. So when I find this, trying to look up this tape, then I would find this record, see that here is more information, see it was mentioned here in this lecture, can jump there and listen to this lecture, find out whether it's true or not what I made a note. Oh, this cross-reference goes back and forth. Cross-reference to another reference or from another reference. And now another feature. There are a lot of features which are here hidden behind these tabs. Cross-reference. Can also find list the processes which are mentioned in the LH issue. You can start from the process, for example, process in the works, processes and remedy. Search for a process, it's a name. For example, date and locate. And here are the works where date and locate is described. Directly jump there. HCB. So now this didn't work as expected. Processes. Right. Yeah. For assist checklist for injuries and illnesses. And this list, date locate is mentioned. Jump there. And here we are. This PDF, I can find date and locate. To join. Back. So we can go by processes and find the references. May be very interesting for CSS, CSing. But all the data we entered here are in German. Now here it's English translation. Murder routine. Murder routine, there's a BTB 72. And so on. So that's just a side remark. It's not the main thing. One thing is very important for me. If you look for books and look for one book and introduction to Scientology ethics. That was my book. And here we are. Use a filter. I have to first remove this filter. Go to this, and now I can look it up. The book Introduction to Scientology Ethics. We have 48 versions of it, mainly English and German, also an audiobook, HTML, text file, docs. And so let's take the version 74. Jump to this. This is the version from 74. And here I find a remark. Here's a publisher, American Sentinel Organization in Los Angeles. And here I find a squirrel alert written by Lone Ranger. And he wrote in the discussion group ACT, Alt Clearing Technology, about the first edition of this book, identical to the 78 issue. And he showed up that there was an alter is in later issues. Because the original said that it is an suppressive act aiding or abetting a person demonstrably guilting of suppressive acts in such acts. So if you are doing suppressive acts, then you are doing a high crime. But today, you do already a high crime if you are just in connection with an SP. That's a big alter is, because everyone is in connection with his piece, at least if he pays his taxes or has an account in a bank account, then they're in connection with his piece. So what I want to show is these discussions. I got this from a discussion group internet and put it to the issue of this book so that I can find this back. If I'm studying the book, I can look at all the scroll alerts. This is just one. I can put in hundreds of comments, of notes about this. And you have all the comments people are finding just there where the issue is stored. We will show another example for this feature. May 17. unreading questions and items. And there we have from Max Howry in 2000 in German language, a critic on this issue. Several critics, and I have three school alerts on this. This is another person, Roland Eldridge, and one from CUS Investigation about a fake HCB moving flows. And here the opinion by Max Howry. So, and that is my idea how we sort out the wheat from the chaff. If we work internationally on the same database, putting in our remarks, our research, to every single issue, whatever we study and find out, we look up this issue and then enter the comment in this field. We could have a nice discussion, which is very valuable for other students. They can read it and get their own mind, their own idea on this after they listen to others. Today I have more than 200 such score alerts entered in this database. It's a good start. Yeah, that is what I wanted to show. I hope it was not too confusing. This is what I created 20 years ago, maybe, and which should be moved to internet in modern database in the cloud with the possibility to download issues you are looking for, which you don't have on your hard drive. But still, you can collect your own references and find them again with the help of the software. Yeah, thank you for listening. And I look forward to your comments. I'm very interested what you think about this and whether you would like to contribute. Thank you and goodbye.